everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'm going to explain about the Anika cloud platform and cloud computing, which is one of the very important topic in cloud computing perspective. So we have many cloud platforms in cloud computing. Among that, in today's video we are going to discuss about Anika cloud platform, and the upcoming videos we will be discussing about the remaining topics of cloud computing. So if you want to receive updates related to the next remaining topics, do subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you can receive the notifications as well. So now, without any further delay, let's get into the video. This Anika cloud platform is an implementation of PaaS model, platform as a service. So it is an implementation of PaaS. We have IaaS also, which is infrastructure as a service, but here this Anika is an implementation of PaaS model. Okay, and it is a platform and also a framework for developing distributed applications on cloud. On cloud, you'll have some distributed applications, right? So in order to develop these distributed applications, this Anika will act as a platform as well as a framework. Okay, and it will also provide a runtime environment. Runtime environment for execution. Runtime environment for executing an application. Right, for executing any application, this Anika will provide us the runtime, and this executions will be already existing. Like these applications will be executed by using the features which are already present in the cloud, right? And also it will provide a set of APIs for developers, right? It will provide a set of APIs for expressing the business logic of the application by using some programming abstractions. Abstractions, in the sense, you know what is abstraction, right? It is one of the OOPS concepts. In abstraction, you will be hiding the implementation. So what you mean is, it will provide APIs. Using this APIs, we can perform abstraction of the business logic which is present in the application. Application will have business logic, right? This business logic can be abstracted. That means the implementation of this business logic can be hidden by using the set of APIs which are provided by Anika. Okay, so this is what it means actually. And it is also a tool for managing the cloud. That means Anika will also provide another feature is, it will provide a tool. This tool is used to manage the cloud. That means what is the amount of storage present and all those. It will manage the cloud, and Anika will also act as a private cloud, a public cloud, and also a hybrid cloud. You know what is a private, public, and hybrid, right? In private, you will have restricted access, and in hybrid, you'll have like, you can integrate the external resources. You can like mix resources according to the, you know, according to the requirement. You can mix the resources and you can create a new cloud, right? That is what hybrid means. And the next concept we are going to learn is Anika container. What do you mean by Anika container? It is a container. Like, it has several services. Before that, let us see. It is a building block of the middleware and also represents the runtime environment for executing an application. As I said, using Anika, you can also execute, right? It will provide the runtime environment for executing. So that is done by this Anika container. Okay, it is a building block of middleware, and also it will provide a runtime environment in order to execute the applications which are present in our cloud. Okay, and this container will provide mainly three types of services, and this services in depth we will be seeing in the Anika cloud architecture diagram. I'll be showing you that also. You have three types of services. You have execution services. In execution services, you'll have all scheduling and execution related services will be present here. Scheduling and execution related services are present here. Next, you have is foundation services. Foundation services, you'll have all the management related services in the foundation services. And the third one is fabric. Fabric services will provide an access to the resources which are, managed by the cloud. Cloud will have some resources, right? Our cloud will have some resources. So you can access to this resources by using this Fabric services. Okay. And one of the very most important service which is present in Fabric services, resource provisioning service. Okay. And this resource provisioning service is done by the platform abstraction layer, right? And this resource provisioning service, what it does is it will make Aneka elastic so that it will grow and it will shrink dynamically according to the requirement, according to the traffic. It will grow and it will shrink, right? So this resource provisioning service will make Aneka elastic with which it can grow and shrink according to the requirement. And this resource provisioning is done by PAL, which is also called as platform abstraction layer. Okay. And the Fabric services will be interacting with the node through this PAL. So I'll show you what is node. Now I will show you the architecture diagram of Aneka. On seeing that diagram, you'll get a clarity, like, you know, all like how the things are organized, you'll be getting to know. Here you have application development and management, right? In this you'll have management, like you'll have a management and software development kit. In management, you'll have tools and interfaces and APIs. I already said you, right? It will provide APIs to perform business logic abstraction. So those APIs and interfaces and some other interfaces. And also I said Aneka will provide a tool for managing the cloud, right? Those tools, all those things will be present in this management, right? And in a software development kit, you'll also have again APIs and tools. Okay. This is the part of application development and management. So whatever the things are related to the application development and management are present here. Next, you'll have your container. I said, right? What do you mean by the container? Container is a basic building block of the middleware. So this is your middleware. And as I said, you'll have three services there: application services, foundation service, and fabric services. Okay. In application services, you'll have distributed threads. You'll have a MapReduce algorithm. You'll have bag of tasks. That means what are the tasks that have to be done. And you'll have also have a PSM. You'll have all the things which are related to application. In application, what do you do? You'll do scheduling of tasks and you'll also do execution, right? So whatever are related to, see, these threads, bag of tasks, all these things are related to scheduling, right? In the same way, whatever are the things related to execution, all those will be present in this application services. Okay. And the next you have is foundation service. As I said, foundation service is responsible for management, right? So in your foundation services, you'll do the management part. So here you'll have storage. That means what is the storage available, what is the storage used, and all those information is here. And resource reservation. And coming to the point of resource reservation, what are the resources that are already reserved and what are the resources that are available, all those things will be stored in this resource reservation. Next you have as billing and reporting. And the next you have is licensing and accounting. All these things are related to management only, right? So all this will come under this foundation services, right? And after foundation services, what do you have? You have fabric services. So what do fabric services do? They will be providing an access to the resources which are managed by the cloud. So cloud will have some resources, right? So using this fabric services only, you can have access to this resources. And let us see what are the services we have in this fabric services. High availability, resource provisioning, hardware profiling, and membership. You'll have all these kind of services in the fabric services. And among all the services present, this resource provisioning is very important. Okay. Because it makes our Aneka elastic, and because of which it can grow and it can shrink according to the requirement. It makes Aneka dynamic. Right. And if you can see here you are having another function, persistence and security. Here, persistence and security is common to all the three services. That means you'll have this in application service, you'll have this in foundation service, you'll also have this in fabric service. So this part is common to all the three things. Okay. And here you have your PAL, platform abstraction layer. And see, what you have below this platform abstraction layer is, you have an infrastructure, right? and you'll have enterprise desktops, grid, data centers, clusters, public clouds. Public clouds means you'll you have AWS, Microsoft Azure, all those are public clouds, right? So you'll have infrastructure. So the interaction between the services and the infrastructure, that means, you know, the physical computers is possible because of this PAL, platform abstraction layer. This platform abstraction layer will enable you to communicate with this node, right? So this is all about Aneka cloud architecture, and this is all about Aneka cloud platform. I hope it was clear for you. I mean, whatever I've explained in the video, I think it was clear for you. I'll just tell what Aneka is again very shortly, right? And Aneka is an implementation of PaaS model, and it is a platform and also a framework for developing distributed applications on cloud, right? And it will provide a runtime environment to execute our applications, and also it will provide a set of APIs to developers, right, with which developers can hide their implementation details, and it will also manage the cloud, and it is available in the form of a public cloud, private cloud, and also hybrid cloud. You know what a public cloud is, right? Accessible to everyone. Private means you'll have some restrictions. Hybrid means you can generate a cloud based on your requirements, right, by integrating different kinds of clouds. And you'll have an Aneka container, which has three types of services: application, foundation, fabric. Application services include services related to scheduling and execution of applications, and foundation includes only management related services. Fabric services includes like how you can access the resources. Using this fabric services, you can access the resources which are present in your cloud. Done. So these are the three different kinds of services we have in Aneka container. Aneka container is nothing but it is a kind of a middleware. It is a foundation for the middleware, right? And also here you have persistence and security, which is common to all the three services which are present in Aneka, right? So done. That's all for this video. I hope the video was useful for you, and if yes, hit the like button and also share it with your friends so that it will be useful for your friends as well. And that's all for this video, and let me know in the comment section how you guys felt about the video, whether it was useful for you, whether you understood it or no, and all those things, because I would like to know what you guys are feeling about the video. And yeah, that's all. So if there are any video recommendations that you guys want to give me, I'm very happy to receive that in the comments. I'll also give you my contact details about my Gmail and Instagram in the description. You can contact me through them as well. And thank you for watching the video. Let's meet up soon in the next coming video.